I can see where contradiction, it seems contradictory.
Well, not so much on that note, but I'm saying has a minority, people who was enslaved by this so-called God that these people serve, I feel like people shouldn't go under the doctrine of that religion. Mm-hmm. Like, if you believe in your God, you could believe in your God, but I have to ask somebody, do you think a Hispanic black man wrote the Bible? No, why? Because they would add themselves in it, just like they add themselves in it. We see angels, they all white. The Jehovah's Witnesses is the only people I know in the group that actually show dominance, diversity of race, and I respect y'all totally for that, because a lot of people don't show that. But this is, I just saying that it's hard for a person like me that read information and be able to come and be like, how can I possibly, knowing that I was stripped from my native language, then was retaught in their language, obviously they know more of the language than I would know. So,
right.
I'm following.
I'm kind of in the same boat too, you know. I remember when I was looking into Jehovah's Witnesses, the tribe, I seen this happening by so-called lovers of God, you know. Mm-hmm. So in the same boat, I kind of, you know, I had to try to solve some of these.
I mean, definitely you. I mean, these people came here to your native land.
Sure, yeah.
Said Thanksgiving and turned around and killed you.
Yeah, so that's, see,
and used their Bible and made it a holiday. Now they just switched it to Indigenous People's Day.
I remember I was in school and I said, I was pretty young, 13, 14. I was learning all about Columbus coming and discovering America. And I kept thinking,
how does that work?
We were already here, you know. Why do they keep saying that? And anyway, I came up. The only thing he discovered was that he was lost.
He was lost.
See, but the thing is, see, now, but the dominant society was, this was in school, it was teaching everybody this, you see.
Programming us.
And so now, there are individuals who have to kind of try to look for the truth, and that's basically what the organization of Jehovah is all about. You know, we're just an organization discovering the truth.
So if I come as a Jehovah's Witness and be like, all right, this is the truth, this Bible only loves certain races, and I'm part of the group, where they say, okay, y'all do the research, say, dang, this is the truth. Will y'all remove that?
What did you just say? You said Jehovah's Witnesses are only diverse.
Yeah.
Now, after 1960, because this same guy was definitely was enslaving people. They didn't like blacks. They didn't allow blacks in their thing. And like I said, they believed that one race started from a 600-year-old couple, Noah and his wife.
Did you know in 1960s how Chicago blew up with Jehovah's Witnesses?
Yeah, and
when they came here, when black people came here, we didn't know white Jehovah's Witnesses because all we knew was black. That's all we grew up with in Chicago.
And when I went down, see, there was a convention down there in Chicago, and from the platform, you know, I mean, it was in the full of Jehovah's Witnesses, and the guy says, now, he says, if you're black, he says, be sure not to cross over some street number, you know, and he says, and if you're white, be sure to stay over here on this side, you know. Anyway, I was like, only where I fit in on this stuff.
Yeah.
and so I was trying to figure that out. Anyway, at the time, I was with a white guy because we were both studying this book. It was a different one. It was called
Truth Book.
Yeah, it was true. It was called a book called Let God Be True.
Yeah.
See, it was kind of like this, but it was just basic doctrines, teachings of the Bible. But so we were rooming together. I said, look, because we came from Minneapolis, we went down to Chicago. I said, look, I don't know about this stuff here, but I'm going over there to get some ribs over there. and he said he would come with me. I said, well, I don't know. They said you're supposed to stay over there. I'm a black guy. I'm going over there. and he came along anyway. And we went with a whole bunch of Jehovah's Witnesses. And the problem was, see, at the time, even at that time, I remember saying that the white brothers that were conducting the meetings, I could often tell that they were prejudiced. And used to irritate me a little bit against black guys. And I used to kind of stand up against that. Of course, then they would put me in my place. Like, something's wrong here. But it never took me away from the truth. Now, these are different, these are individuals, but the truth of God's Word. One truth is that God made friends with Abraham. You remember that. He made a little covenant with him, a little promise.
A covenant, but Abraham had to live out the covenant. Not God. God didn't need Abraham. Abraham needed God.
Right. And it was
through Isaac.
Basically, right. He just said, if you do this and you do that,
I will bless a nation after you.
Your kids, as a result, will bless all
except
the
for nations. Ishmael, because he got the African mother, so I get him to a prince who's going to watch life. But this white baby, we're going to get the tribe of Israel about him.
At that time, there was no, he didn't have a nation. Jehovah was establishing a nation, and they weren't white. They were Oriental, if anything. You know?
They said they was Edomites. Well, that's white.
Abraham was the first, the great-grandson of Shem.
Mm-hmm. Was an Edomite.
Shem, you know, what, we don't, they're Noah.
Edomite.
The three boys.
One was Ham.
They had the three boys. But from them came the various groups of people that eventually turned into nations. In the meantime, Jehovah was establishing or developing his own nation.
So God got to develop his own nation. All-knowing God.
Well, if you think
God
about
developed his own nation.
You think about it.
He wiped out.
He wiped it out.
He wiped it completely out.
Why?
So, and you just think about it. He wiped it out. So
why?
That's right.
He wiped it out. The world became wicked again. So guess what? That means Noah's kids and they. So his kids had to have been having relations with their kids to form these nations. It wasn't something that Jehovah just said, okay, here go a black person down here. You meet up with this white person, y'all have kids, and it's over with.
Why? Because that old Cain did when he just mysteriously left and had a wife and had a child named Enoch.
Yeah, but where
they come from? Said the first people was Adam and Eve.
It was Adam and Eve.
See, and the Bible says that Adam and Eve
had other kids.
Yeah.
Where say that in the Bible?
Right in the Bible, yeah.
Well, because I did not see that nowhere. You got internet on there? You can probably Google it and see, because I haven't seen it. I heard it after Genesis 4 chapter when they talk about Steph, because he's the coming second making of Abel.
Basically, you know, Adam and Eve had sex and had a lot of kids.
Mm-hmm. Before they got kicked out of the garden, is what you're saying?
No, afterwards.
Afterwards.
So, with that being said, and they said they only had two kids, specifically at this time.
But see, the Bible also said he had other kids. He didn't name them.
Oh, he said you name your children after you, Adam.
Yeah.
He's saying after you, name your children. Name your children.
Sure.
But prior.
And Jehovah has decided to name, just those two, because he could teach the following humans certain lessons.
Why? If this God is all loving God,
Jehovah, yeah,
and He say, Jehovah say, I want to be able to cause confusion in the world.
Jehovah didn't say that.
Well, that's what He doing.
Well, Satan is doing that.
you let him off.
So
that was the first act of deception. That was Satan. Which Satan was an angel. He was right there with Jehovah God.
So why would he be jealous? So why